wanted to kind of teach them more about ballet, so obviously, we needed a way to let people know what we were doing, and we just thought that was during their first class, and none of them really knew what they were doing, and they all looked really hilarious. So that was how we got people to know. We tweeted it out, and then it'll also be on the oil spill today during second hour because the performance is today. So this is what we wanted to do for our presentation, but obviously we needed a main goal for what we wanted to accomplish. And so we decided the three things we wanted to do were educate football players and just other students about fine arts and what it takes to do ballet. Because it takes a lot more than what a lot of people realize on the surface level. There's a lot of strength and flexibility and stamina that goes into performing ballet. And then we wanted to help the football players improve as well. There's a lot of statistics going in to show that ballet actually helps improve football players' agility and speed. And it also helps with their footwork a lot. And then finally, we wanted to bring people together with the performance. So we thought the performance would be a really fun way to bring lots of people into the auditorium during lunches to watch the football players perform what they have accomplished these last couple weeks in just a fun, entertaining way to bring everyone from the school together.
For our research for this project, what kind of like made us think about the idea of doing this was the Game Plan movie. It's about an NFL player who goes to ballet class with his daughter, and he ends up joining the class, and then it helps him to win the championship football game because he like leaps gracefully over another football player. So that's what kind of made us think about it, and then we did some more real world research, and we found Steve McGlendon, who's also an NFL player who takes ballet class regularly, and he talked about how it's a really good cross training for football because it uses a lot of the same muscles and helps build, like Warren was talking about, like balance, flexibility, speed, strength. So it's just a really good for football players to take ballet.
And then we made a timeline of what our project took to complete, because it actually took a lot more work than what you kind of realize on the surface level. So the first thing we needed to do was figure out if football players would actually participate in our project, because we didn't know if they were going to just think we're crazy trying to get them to take a couple ballet classes. So we decided, based off the space we had and the resources we had, that we didn't want any more than 12 football players to sign up. And it actually worked out perfectly. We had exactly 12. Unfortunately, only 10 of them were able to actually come and be in the performance today, but that's still a really great number, and we were really excited about it. And then the next thing we needed to do was...
We had to talk to Mr. Black, who owns Off-Broadway Performing Arts Studio. That's the studio that I go to. And also, he's obviously the drama director, teacher here at MPHS, so we needed to talk to him about using the auditorium for our performance. So we used the studio space. He allowed us to use it for two classes, and then today we're going to use the auditorium for our performance during lunch.
We also needed to make sure that once we got the players to sign up, that they would be able to have access to information and know when our classes were and what we would be doing. And so these are some little like quarter pieces of paper that we handed out to all of them. Obviously the information changed a little bit. We kind of had to go with the flow and work with when auditorium space was available and when football players were available, just because there's lots of like NHS and track going on right now. So we had to change it a little bit, but this was just our way of making sure all of the football players were informed of what was going on.
And then we had the two classes at the studio. The first class, my ballet teacher taught, and so it was more of like a professional ballet class than just like having fun. So they really liked that. And then the second one, me and Lauren taught, and it was basically just getting ready for the performance, like what they were gonna do during it. So they went really well.
And the last thing, well, one of the last things we needed to do was make sure people knew about our performance. And so that's where the commercial we made came into play with footage from the first class we took. And then we also tweeted out about it and posted on the Class of 2017 Facebook page. And then we've been selling tickets. We started yesterday and we'll keep selling them today and then right up until the performances start. And these were just the little tickets we made to let people know when they were and just so that obviously you know if they bought a ticket or not.
And then the last thing that we're gonna do after our performance is donate all the money that we make to the Pillars Fund, which helps improve the stadium. So it'll go back to the community and also the football players themselves.
So kind of what Grace was just talking about, we wanna donate all of the proceeds we make to the Pillars Foundation or Pillars Fund. And the reason we wanted to turn this into a fundraiser is because we could just do the classes with the football players and just help them improve and stuff, but we wanted to kind of have a bit of a bigger impact on the community and the school than just the 10 football players that were able to come. So we decided to turn it into a $2 for each ticket and then donate it all back to the football stadium so that we could give back to the football players for the field they're playing on, and then also back to the community and any of the students that enjoy coming to the football games to make that a better environment for everyone.
So we also wanted to like impact the football players themselves and talking about ballet, and so I made this little video just about their thoughts after the class and how they thought about ballet. So.
How do you feel after the class?
Demonstration of what happened in the class. So it's not really like this is a ballet dance. It's just like they're gonna do like a standard ballet class for everyone, and I'm gonna be in it too. So you can kind of compare like me with versus them. So
you'll be able to see what ballet is supposed to look like, and then what you're able to learn from ballet after just two classes, which isn't very much. There's a lot that goes into ballet that they unfortunately weren't able to learn in the short time we had, but. Our goal is to raise $100, as Grace said. We want 50 people to come, approximately 25 people for each lunch. We figured that would be a decent-sized crowd for our student project. And we're actually selling tickets right now. If you guys want to buy one, we hope you can all come. It's going to be really amazing. The guys are actually super, super excited about the whole thing, and they were the ones that decided they wanted to wear tutus. So if you are interested in seeing some of the junior and senior football players dance in tutus with ballet, classical music in the background, you should definitely come check it out. It'll be really great. It's the last 10 or 15 minutes of both lunches, so whatever lunch you have, just show up within the last 15 minutes, buy your ticket at the door or from us right now, and enjoy.